This tutorial is brought to you by PhotoshopTalent.com. From Ice Flow Studios, and in this beginner tutorial, we're going to be discussing the clone stamp tool and what exactly it can be used for. To begin this tutorial, we're going to start off by locating the clone stamp. The clone stamp is located in our tools palette at the left-hand side of our screen, and it is this button right here. And if we hover our mouse over it, we will notice that it says clone stamp tool with an S beside it. Basically, if you want to very quickly select the clone stamp tool, just press the letter S on your keyboard and you will select it. So what can the clone stamp be used for? Well, basically the clone stamp is used to fix blemishes and to get rid of unwanted areas in your image. For instance, in this image right here of this car that I took at the Toronto Auto Show, let's say, for example, I want to get rid of this white highlight. Well, using the clone stamp, we can do exactly that. Before we begin, we're going to set a few options. At the top here, where our sub-objects are, we're going to set our brush size. I'm going to start off with 25. I'm going to show you exactly how to adjust the settings very quickly in a second. I'm going to set the hardness to 0. I'm going to make sure opacity is set to 100% and flow at 50. Once those are all set, we're going to begin. Now, what I like to do, I like to get my brush size approximately the size, maybe a tiny bit bigger, than the blemish that I want to fix. So without having to go back up to the top and grab our menu and adjust the brush size like that and then go back down to make sure it's correct, we can use the bracket keys on our keyboard. They are right near our enter or return key. And the right bracket key increases the size of our brush, like so, and the left bracket key decreases the size of our brush. So I'm going to put it approximately there. Now we're ready to begin. This is how the clone stamp works. Basically, what we have to do now is sample an area that we want our blemish to look like. So let's say, for instance, I want this blemish here to look like this paint. What we're going to do, if you're on a Mac, hold down Option. If you're on a PC, hold down Alt. And you'll notice that our cursor has turned into a crosshair. Basically, we are telling Photoshop to sample the area underneath this crosshair. So once we have our crosshair, we're just going to click our mouse, like so. And that has sampled the area underneath the crosshair. And now you can let go of Alt or Option. And now the only thing left to do is to start using our brush. And it works just like the brush tool. We're just going to start brushing away, like so. And you'll notice that a crosshair appears at the top left. And that's basically showing you where the sampled area is. And that is pretty much about it. You can go around and sample a new area if you want and brush over, like so, and you'll notice that the sampled area always remains in view. And once you're happy with the result, that's about it. And as you notice, the highlight is gone. And if we look at what we had before, this is our original, and after using our clone stamp, that's what we have now. So it looks very seamless, very flawless. It's a great tool to get rid of blemishes and unwanted areas in your image. So I hope you learned something from this tutorial. I hope you apply these to your projects. If you're on YouTube, rate this video, comment the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And this has been Howard from Ice Flow Studios. And until next time, take care.